Now then, as a special part of the ongoing celebrations, I'm pleased to say that Manic Street Preachers have lent their support for Radio Wales Music Day. Fair play to them. Because earlier in the week, Bethan spoke to singer James Dean Bradfield. You got a key to his door then, didn't you, really? Fair play, you had a chat with him?
I had a lovely chat with him, and they were still busy mixing the track as when we spoke earlier in the week, but I started off by asking him what they decided to do to lend their weight to Radio Wales Music Day.
Myself and the boys, we've done a version of a track called The Endless Plane of Fortune, which was, it's a John Cale song, off his kind of seminal album, Paris 1919. And, we've done quite a faithful version of it. It was always my favourite song off that album. And in our heads, this is our chance to almost pretend like we were the band, as in the band, with Robbie Robertson, etc., you know, back in our version of Bob Dylan, which would be John Cale. So kind of like, it was a good little kind of like game in our heads where, you know, we could pretend that we were in the 70s back in John Cale. It just felt really cool.
I like the image. The album itself, you've sort of spoken before about how much of a fan you are of John Cale's music. And would this be your favourite album?
Yeah, no, definitely. I think for me, kind of Paris 1919 is definitely the moment where everything just came together. Subsequently, you know, there are other great albums he did, but for me, that is the benchmark for me. In terms of Welsh music, you know, in terms of a Welsh solo artist, that is the album. And I was lucky enough to see him perform the entire album at the Coal Exchange last year. And that was something I thought I'd never see. So kind of like, you know, I've actually seen that album perform live now in Cardiff, and we've actually, you know, played one of these songs in its entirety and done quite a faithful version of it as well. So perhaps I can let go of my obsession after this.
He's quite a formidable character, John Cale, with the, you know, I think it's the weight of the past, the fact that he was a part of the Velvet Underground. But you had a chance to work with him on a film in the past. Tell us a little bit about that, James.
Yeah, no, I mean, kind of, Mark Evans did this kind of like this coming home kind of documentary called Beautiful Mistake, where it was kind of, I think it was around about 1998, I think, where what the period was called Cool Cymru, so to speak. And, you know, you had people like, you know, the Gorkies and Catatonia and, you know, Super Furry Animals and Phonics at the top of their game. And and the Gorkies, Catatonia and Furries and myself were part of that documentary. And kind of it was just us, you know, playing some of his songs with him as part of this homecoming and seeing if he could reconnect with the whole new generation of, like, Welsh musicians. And, that was definitely one of the most nerve-wracking experiences I've ever had as a musician. And I just remember, you know, at that time, you know, all John would do was come in every day and just do the Times crossword obsessively and drink lots of coffee. And then we'd play a song. So it was, you kind of had to have your game face on. You know, you had to be prepared and you had to know all the chords and the tricky time signatures and stuff. So it was a kind of, it was quite nerve-wracking at the time, but it was a great memory.
Well, I really look forward to seeing what you've done with the track, with the John Cale track. But at the same time, a lot of musicians are kind of whispering about maybe choosing a Mannix track to cover on this Welsh Music Day. And, you know, in recent times as well, Griff Rhys did a wonderful version recently of Designed for Life. I'm sure Nicky Y has been talking about it online. So how do you feel about the idea of people doing your music as covers?
Well, I mean, there's not many people have really ever attempted to do covers of our songs. I remember the Boo Radleys once did a cover of Four Stone, 7 Pounds off the Holy Bible, which we were really shocked at, but we loved. And then, you know, just a month back, I heard, you know, a gross version of Design for Life, and he'd almost turned it into a kind of like a homestead kind of like folk song. It's almost as if the song had been written 200 years ago and he'd gone back to the original arrangement. It was quite strange hearing him do hearing what he'd done to it, but it was beautiful. He'd taken almost some kind of hidden rudiments of the song and turned it into something so much more traditional, and I was knocked out when I heard it, to be honest. And it's such a strange experience for us hearing other people cover our songs, because it barely ever happens. I think the only other example I could think of is there was a really, really strange Italian house version of If It's All Right, This Your Children Will Be Next, knocking around in around about year 2000. So that was quite a shock. But it's definitely, you know, Chris' version of Design for Life is definitely, and you have the best cover that we've heard of one of our songs, definitely.
Yeah, I'm sure there's going to be a few nervous musicians now getting ready to do their versions of some of your songs.
They're going to have to learn how to sing a bit high first, I think.
Well, James Dean Bradfield, once again, it's lovely to catch up with you, and thank you so much for preparing this track. Can't wait to hear it now. This is a cover then of John Cale by the Manic Street Preachers, featuring the Vulcan String Quartet and John Ray. This is The Endless Plane of Fortune.